Did you know that 23% of people watching this YouTube channel turn on the closed captions? I'm not making that up. I just checked the analytics. Almost 1 in 4 people will turn on the subtitles to know exactly what I'm saying. That's a lot of people. Now, I'd like to think that my British accent, speaking only the finest Queen's English, would make my videos easy to understand, but the truth of the matter is, a big portion of the internet and your potential audience on Twitch may suffer from hearing loss or not having English as their first language, or simply wanting to watch content in a place where they can't listen to the audio. Now, did you know that just like with YouTube videos, Twitch also has the ability to show closed captions, but on your live streams, where anybody that is watching your live stream can just click one little button on the player and see closed captions to show exactly what you're saying. And no, I'm not talking about needing to enable some kind of Twitch extension or open up a website every single time you stream. I'm talking about functionality that's built directly into Twitch, where your viewers can choose to enable the subtitles in live streams or VODs on desktop or on mobile, and it's completely free and easy to set up with OBS Studio. It's a no-brainer. Just before we dive in, I'd like to thank the sponsor of this video, which is Melon. Now, Melon is a web-based live streaming studio where you can create professional live streams in seconds with no downloads or any software needed. You can easily invite guests onto your show by just copying a link. They don't even need an account, and you can of course customize the stream with your own branding, lower thirds, and colors or backgrounds. You can even stream to 4 different platforms simultaneously right from your browser. To get started with Melon, simply visit the link down in the description below. Right, let's jump onto the PC and get these closed captions set up. Okay, so what we need to do firstly is make sure that we have OBS Studio closed because we're gonna be installing a plugin. Head down to the description and open up the link that I have linked there. It'll take you to this GitHub repository for the plugin that we're gonna be installing into OBS Studio. All you need to do is choose the latest version. I've been using this 0.18 beta with absolutely no issues the past couple of weeks. So choose your operating system. For me, that's Windows. Download the zip file, and then inside the zip file, we're going to have an OBS plugins folder. Just drag that across to wherever you have installed OBS Studio. Usually, that is your C drive, program files, OBS Studio. And if you drag that across, Windows will probably ask for some permissions just to make sure you can overwrite the files. So just click continue, continue, continue. This is a super lightweight plugin, so it shouldn't have any impact on the performance of your PC. And effectively, all it's doing is taking the raw input from your microphone, sending that across to Google's transcribing services, transcribing it, taking that data back, and then sending it across the official channels to Twitch so that your viewers can enable it if they wish to. So now that that's installed, we can open back up OBS Studio. To check that the plugin installed correctly, you can simply come up to the tools menu here and you should have a new option called Cloud Closed Captions. If you click that, we'll open up a new box where there'll be a settings window where we will now configure the plugin. First option that we're going to change is this caption source, and you want to select here the raw microphone that you are using. So for me, that is ChatMic Go XLR because this microphone goes through my Go XLR, but you basically want to set here the microphone that you're using, whatever it's called, in OBS Studio and in Windows. If you're using something like the Elgato Wave or a Go XLR and this all your audio gets mixed together into one channel, you'll still here want to select the raw microphone input if you can. So make sure that's added and then select it here. The caption when option, this is basically choosing when you want to write captions. So here the default of caption source is heard on stream. This basically means that if you ever mute your main microphone, it won't keep making captions, which is really useful if you ever need to take a phone call or something whilst you're on stream and you don't want that still to be captioned for your audience potentially leaking unwanted info. Next, you want to set the language that you are speaking. So I'm not from the United States, I am from the United Kingdom. So I'm gonna set my language to English, United Kingdom. And we can choose where we want to output the captions to. So whether that's streams only, your local recordings, a combination of both, or just to disable it completely. I'm just gonna enable this for my streams, but you can set this up to output the subtitles for VODs as well. The next few options can just be left at their defaults. I wouldn't recommend changing lines from 3 because currently on Twitch it's not really supported, and everything else can be left at their defaults. That's pretty much it for the settings, but I do wanna point out that this plugin has plenty more functionality. If you want to save your transcript into SRT files that you then upload to YouTube or use on TikTok or Instagram, and you can even do some text replacements if there's some common words that it keeps getting wrong, maybe some technical terms from a game that you're playing, you can actually set it to replace certain words with others. But we're gonna just cover the basics in this tutorial. So we've set up our caption source, our caption when, and our language, and where we want to output it to, and that's all we need to do for now. Just before we enable the caption service, if we click save and close down this preview box, you should have a doc showing of the captions
If you don't, you can come up to View Docs and make sure you have captions checked. And of course, because this is OBS Studio, you can drag and position this dock wherever you would like. And at any time, you can just jump back into the settings by clicking this cogwheel. You can see right now we have closed captions disabled because haven't enabled it yet. So if we come up to captioning enabled, tick that, click save again, and then we can open up the settings and click show preview to actually show it even though we're not streaming. So as soon as you start streaming, this would normally enable, but we can test it by clicking show preview. Now this sometimes takes around 10 seconds to actually start working to hook onto the Google transcribing API. I think it's actually Google Text-to-Speech, which is the same service that YouTube uses, but you can see now it is transcribing what I'm saying and writing it out, which will now display on my stream if people choose to enable it on Twitch. So now that we've set up the streamer side of the closed caption plugin, how do your viewers actually enable captions on your stream? Because like I mentioned at the beginning, this is down to the viewers if they want to enable or disable it. They're not hard embedded into your stream. So next time you go live on Twitch, your viewers will see a little CC button here on the Twitch player, which they can click to enable the closed captions and click again to disable. They also have complete control over the appearance of the captions on their end by opening up the closed caption options here, where they can customize the text and background colors through some presets that they've already made for you, or then they can really customize things if they want to change the font, size, color, alignment, position, and opacity of the captions. These same options of enabling and disabling captions will also be available to anyone watching your VODs on Twitch. So it's not just for when you're live streaming, people watching your VODs will also be able to enable captions if they wish to. I'd still recommend probably having a chat command or a timed message, just letting people know how they can enable and disable the captions if they wish to. It's just worth educating your audience in how they can get the most out of your streams. If you're running a dual PC setup with a gaming PC and a streaming PC, and you're using like a mixer that mixes all of your audio sources together, so your streaming PC only receives one audio source, then this is going to be a little bit more tricky to set up because you want to still just send the raw audio to the Google transcribing API and not your mixed audio, which has game sounds and music and alerts and things like that in, because you want it just to be your microphone that is being captioned. If that is your use case, it's actually relatively simple to fix. So if we look down here in OBS, I have a broadcast stream mix, which is my microphone, but everything else included in that, my game audio, my alerts, so things that I don't want to be transcribed. What we need to do is open up our settings and make sure that we add a second audio source. So here a mic auxiliary audio 2, we add our microphone, which is our chat mic, add that, and you can see it down at the bottom. You'll then want to mute that source so that your stream doesn't hear your voice twice and it's just still hearing the broadcast stream mix. And then in our caption settings, we change the caption source to be our mic only input, which is mic aux 2. And then we change our caption when mute source is heard on stream. So that's the main setting that you need to change. And then we set our mute source to be our broadcast stream mix. This basically just means that we're still just captioning our microphone, and we're going to caption when the stream mix is heard on stream. So if we still mute our stream mix at any point, it's going to stop the captions from going through. That's the only difference with a complex dual PC setup, really, if you still want to do closed captioning. Hopefully this video has been helpful and you now have closed captions set up for your live streams on Twitch. If you're somebody that watches with closed captions on YouTube, why don't you share this video with your favorite streamers and let them know it really only takes them a few minutes to set up closed captioning for their Twitch streams, and it can be enabled and disabled by the viewers completely, and it just makes their stream way more accessible to people watching on the internet. So hopefully this has been helpful. Give it a thumbs up if it has, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace. Very famous Fortnite streamer, one of the people that got their own skin in the game, where she tweeted that she's falling out of love with making content. And I think she then broke down a little bit after that. Let's just go into that because I'm already describing it anyway. Microsoft, you can wait. Your $10 billion deal can wait until the end of our podcast.